The Brothers Geek Out podcast episode 150.
We've got
special guest Ash and Yaku to talk about. I don't know.
The geeky stuff.
It's the geeky stuff, but we're gonna jump straight in. Hope you guys have been well. Make sure you check us out on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and on something else, right?
Sorry.
Apple Podcasts, Spotify, YouTube,
SoundCloud.
And
we're trying to get on Amazon, so
is it bestobscenity.com?
Well, I was going to say something else, but I shouldn't say it.
Nah, man, don't say that, man. Problems.
Oh, my God.
We're watching The Avengers as we do this podcast today.
Episode 150, so it's a landmark episode. So 150 episodes so far, guys. I know I've only got, I don't even know how many I've got up on the other platforms, but on YouTube, 150.
I think we started on 100, didn't we, on the other platforms?
Just SoundCloud, I think. The rest of them have been quite less, but yeah. We did a massive episode with Yakub on Passion. That's on... Actually, you know what? That's not going to come out for until next month, so... check it out next month.
Look out for that one.
Yeah, keep an eye out for that one. But Yaku's going to join us on this special one. But yeah, let's start off, G-Man.
Well,
loads have happened, so we're just going to jump straight in.
Let's go into some of the movies that we watched, just real quick. Some of the old school ones. Because Disney Star, I know last week we commented on it.
Yes, Disney Star.
But you know what? Like, first of all, you didn't get charged double. It was a part of your package.
Yeah,
how much do you pay?
You didn't pay extra. It came a part of his package. No. Yeah.
$59.99 a year.
Yeah. Secondly, some of the movies that have come, bro, I've been moist, bro. Yeah. So I've watched... Okay, I did watch Stop on My Mama Shoot. That was on Netflix. I just wanted to bring that up because that was freaking awesome, man. I was watching it with Mum and Dad was loving it. Like, yeah. I don't think he's seen it before and he was just cracking up. So shout out to Stallone for that, for his attempt of comedy.
Do you know Arnold was supposed to do that movie, yeah?
What? Are you serious?
Yeah, so he
Stop on My Mum.
Arnold made Stallone do it.
Oh, are you serious?
Stallone played it so well on that movie.
It was good, man. It was good. I still love the movies, man. I got enough respect for them guys anyway, man.
Yeah, so. Man.
I like the funny Stallone. Great. I think he does it really well.
Yeah.
Great movie. Anyway, so I just wanted to bring that up. And then we watched last week Judas and the Black Messiah.
Oh,
that was a good brilliant fucking movie. Have you seen it?
No, I need to see it.
Brilliant movie, man. The main dude, what's his name?
Daniel Calicoco, was it?
Yeah, something like that. Bro, he's fucking awesome. He played it really well. We learned a lot about... Like, when you heard about the Black Panther movement, like, you just think it was a black group, but it was more against the government in this. It was a political party, basically. Mm-hmm. Like, he literally, this dude, who did he play? What's his name? Do you remember his name?
Oh, I forgot.
Fundamental member of the Black Panthers, anyway. But they would go into, like for example, they would recruit like Hispanic community, the white community, and not even just the normal white. I'm talking about the white
Confederates,
man. He'll walk into there and they'll talk to them and relate to them. Like, this is a black dude walking into a Confederate meeting and relate to them on their situation and whatnot. And that's when you think about the Black Panthers, it's not just black people. It was
everybody.
It was everybody. It was a movement. And then just the way, I mean, look, if you haven't seen it, you need to check it out. It's fucking powerful. Just at the end of it, the way they express how the FBI literally went in there like a mafia gang and killed them.
Bro,
I spoil it for you. But it's a true story anyways. It's fact. It's history.
It's a historical event, yeah.
It's deep, so it's, man. I still want to watch it and get surprised,
you
bro.
You seen right. it?
No, man.
My bad. But Lewis, it's a historical moment anyway, bro.
Lewis.
But,
I haven't seen it,
watch it. It's brilliant. Jeez. Like I said, like...
Spoiled. Spoilers, guys, spoilers.
But no, but you'll be shocked at the fact that the way they were executed, literally, it was like a mob attack.
Right, he was going to give a backhander, did you see that?
But very good movie, man. So I recommend that. Watch that. And Daniel is a freaking amazing actor.
He looks so young.
He does such a brilliant role.
Yeah.
The accent, the body language.
Oh, yeah, everything.
The way he just delivers, smacked it.
And this was after Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Huey P. They were all dead at this point, right?
Huh.
If I'm correct, was Huey P. still alive?
Just saw me yawn there, man. He's still alive. Back of my throat.
Okay. Right. But Malcolm X and this was after Malcolm X and Martin Luther King, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, great, again, another great piece of history with the Black Panthers, and just to understand them a bit more, because again, I think people just think that they were just black people and they hated white people. That was not the case with the Black Panthers. Again, I'm not a Black Panther expert. I don't think none of us are, but I don't think it was just that. There's more to it. So great movie. Check that one out. And then Disney Star. I mentioned Disney Star, but those two movies we didn't watch on Disney Star. So let's go into some of the Disney Star movies I watched. I watched The Renaissance Man with Danny DeVito, 1994, I think it was. And then Fugitives with Martin Short, 1989. But that's another classic movie, man.
No, I love that movie. It's a good movie. Renaissance Man's good. Renaissance Man,
Mark Wahlberg,
brought back some good memories, man.
Oh, young Mark Wahlberg cracked me up, man.
But all of them actors, man, because now they're like old school now. But Dan DeVito, man, he's got a really good charisma, and the way he picks his films and his stories are really good. But that film always had a it's always a good film movie, that is. Always,
yeah, man. Definitely, always, man. So, hey, man, I'm impressed with Disney Star, man. They got a good few movies I want to watch. The Great White Hope, again, with Mark Wahlberg and
Samuel Jackson
and Damon Wayans. That was hilarious. Mm. I saw some other classic ones that I want to watch. We watched... what do you call it, man? What's the one with Ben Stiller we watched, a comedy?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, a Neighborhood Watch.
Neighborhood Watch, again, that film was hilarious. So good, yeah, good films from Disney Star. So definitely impressed with it. It just came out in Singapore, so my Singapore friends are all watching Disney Plus and whatnot. It took ages, but finally they got it. The other thing I watched was there's a new Netflix show called Age of Samurai, Battle of Japan. Oh, have you seen that, Gibbs?
Not yet, I saw my list.
We saw episode one, really good, man. I guess it's just talking about Japan in its old samurai days and the impact of that time and, you know, there's the civil war and the conquerorship of Japan. And if you're into the samurai culture and whatnot, definitely one to check out.
What platform, Disney?
That was Netflix. Check that one out, bro. Right. It's kind of wicked. Kind of awesome, bro. Alright, cool. Let's get into some other geeky stuff, man. Kibbs, did you hear about Jennifer Lawrence as Susan Storm?
That's what
possible rumours. Yeah,
no
possible rumours. Yeah. What'd you think about that?
I heard that. I don't want her in it.
Why?
Nah, man.
She was Mystique,
I
mean,
innit? Nah, man. Do you feel like she's done
just move,
the whole
move.
Superhero feel?
Sorry, please. Oh,
choose someone
what's
else.
What's going on there, man?
She's Oscar winning, right? She
needs to move away. Nah, man, I don't think she'd be. For me personally, I just want somebody new, a new actress, I don't want her to be in that. I just feel like everything will be revolved around her.
Mm.
The reason why she was stuck in those X-Men movies, which is only a few of them, which were good, but they revolved it around her because she was big at the time.
Yeah, I was going to say that.
Mystique, yeah. They made Mystique the leader of the X-Men.
Oh, my
because
God.
I mean, yes, I agree with that. Yeah.
Nah, man. It's only because she was getting big at the time. People were going to go watch her because they're in there and then... Sorry, guys.
God. Jesus. Damn, kids.
Sorry,
did you just let...
Yeah. Always fighting on the podcast, man.
It's a new thing there, man.
I'm sleeping, man. Allow it.
It's not that loud, man. Can you make tea?
Yeah. Well, you say it's asthma off now.
Isn't it?
Basic. But yeah, no, you
and
know
French,
what?
Bro.
I didn't think
deep.
About it from that perspective, but I don't think... You know what the thing is? I'll tell you what, with Marvel, they don't do that. And Fox did that because they wanted viewership, they wanted blockbuster, but I don't think Marvel will follow that. They really focus on all their characters and character development. But they don't. Marvel's shown that they don't need Oscar-winning stars to get, you know, viewers and blockbuster hits and stuff. Where you going, bro? So yeah, that's just a rumor for now. Anyway, nothing's confirmed. Did you?
Whoa.
What have you done, bro?
Nothing. Why did I open my level?
Damn. Did you see Ash? Did you see the first look of Shang-Chi?
I saw it on Facebook, but I didn't click into it.
The Lego. It was the Lego toy that exposed it.
Oh no way.
Yeah, I don't know if that's the actual costume, but. It was a Lego toy. And I don't know why the Lego toy come out when even the movie's not out yet. But it had the first look of him, so...
But I have always realised there was, it's always a toy that gives it away.
Well, Lego fucked up Civil War. Remember, it had Giant Man and stuff. Yeah. I don't know why, but Shang-Chi's not even... I don't even know when the release date is, so I'm surprised a Lego toy came out.
Release date yet, have they?
I'm not sure, man. Obviously, things got delayed. But, yeah.
I did see a picture on Facebook, the Eternals.
Yeah.
And a picture of all of them. But I don't know if it's fake.
I don't think that was the actual... I think that was like a sketch image, like a drawing.
Yeah.
Talking about Shang-Chi, did you see the...
Yeah, it's from the Lego box.
Yeah.
So it'd probably be the same.
But yeah, Lego.
I'm a bit interested to see.
Alright, what about big news this week, man, on Spider-Man? No Way Home. We even get that title.
Yeah, no, it's got... They kept it with the trilogy, so... There's more to it. So because that introduced...
They had so many names and No Way Home or E.T. Home or... They had so many names and you could... It kept you thinking, what are they actually going to call it?
Exactly.
But there's No Way Home definitely relate to the multiverse, right? Because there's No Way Home.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
But there's rumours that's Tom Holland's last one.
Yeah, his contract was already signed one up.
Must have put something out saying, look, hey, there was a Spider-Man before him, and there's going to be a Spider-Man after him.
Yeah. Is that what Robert Downey Jr. said?
Yeah. Not in that exact word for word, but along the lines, look, there was someone before Toby, there was someone after Toby Maguire, and there's going to be someone after Tom Holland, so don't worry, guys.
Marvel's going to keep Tom Holland. They'll do whatever they can to keep him. They're good at doing that shit. And Tom Holland's so young, they got so much time with him.
Yeah, I think they will.
Cool. I also read that Happy Gilmore 2.
No,
Adam Sandler looking to make a Happy Gilmore 2. What do you think about that, Yak? Because I know you're an Adam Sandler fan.
I love the guy, man. Ever since, what's that? Was it Billy? It is
Billy Madison.
Billy Madison. Yeah. I love the guy. Mr. Deeds, Family Guy. Was it Family Guy?
Wedding Singer.
Yeah. Oh, man. Always loved the dude. So I'm looking forward to that. I know a lot of people say he's the same dude in every film, but I love the dude he plays. Yeah, all his films, he just does a good role.
Hubert. Was it Hubert?
Yeah, he plays that, you know, that dopey character type of...
No, you know what?
Little Nicky.
Sorry, you guys can get peep show, man.
Oh, damn. Tight boxer shorts?
Yeah, why?
Well, show on the podcast, bro.
Fire's looking tight, kids, man.
Don't you let your piece breathe, bro?
No, man, shut up.
Why? Because it's got something on the thighs.
Why are we checking him getting changed?
I don't know. Kim, do the silhouette challenge, man. Do the silhouette. Come in front of us. Do the silhouette challenge.
No, man.
Oh, my God. Yeah. So, Adam Sandler, man, since I was a kid in secondary school, this guy's been making films. And the films he used to make back then, he could never do today. But now he makes films which are more family-orientated. And I like that because now I like watching films with my kids. Certain films that have a lot of profanity, I just can't watch it with my kids. I just don't feel right. So now most of his films are aimed at that level where it's the profanity level is controlled and it's more family orientated.
No, bro, grown-ups is not, bro. And that's the PG.
That has adult connotation, but it is actually for kids. When you look at it properly, like there's some sexual reference when, you know, the daughters come up and they're all... Make that little pose and look this way, that way. Do you remember? But otherwise, it's...
I do think Adam Sandler... I love his movies, man. Every single one of them.
He's doing Zohan too.
They're watching Zohan. Oh, my God. Yeah. I think my favourite is Zohan.
My favourite is Zohan and Uncut Gems, man.
Obviously, that was... Yeah, apart from his comedy, because that was a very serious movie and that got... He got, I guess... He got nominated for an Oscar, right? I mean, he was fucking brilliant in that.
He was.
But that just goes to show how good of an actor he is. He could do those roles if he wanted to. But I think his passion is behind the Happy Gilmore...
Yeah, I'm just singing.
Happy Gilmore Productions.
Somebody kill me, please. Somebody, pretty, pretty, please, kill me. I want to die.
You should grow your hair.
Put a bullet in my head.
Grow your hair like that as well. Yeah, the curly-whirlies, don't you?
He was brilliant.
Wedding Singer, that was a good one, man. But yeah, anyway, I mean, it says Happy Gilmore 2. I think hopefully it's in the making. He also made rumors about making a universe with all his characters, so that'd be awesome as well.
Really?
Yeah, could you imagine? Yeah, that'd all of his awesome. Characters coming back.
Didn't he make a film Overtime or Bedtime or Nighttime or something with the remote control?
Oh,
Click.
Yeah, click. That was quite cool. Yeah. It was deep, really, if you think about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, of course.
Oh, the message behind it.
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful.
And that's one thing I like about this film. There's always an underlying message. Either give someone a chance or respect that person. Or
waste your time.
Yeah, or, you know, see the beauty in that person.
Yeah. Like, and also family, man. Yeah. Like, he spent all his time working and didn't really make time for his family. Yeah. And it was just about, fuck work, like, spend all the time with the family, man. That's what's the most important. But moving on, Amber Heard fired from Aquaman 2, apparently. Is that true? Or am I fake news?
I think it's confirmed.
Well, there's been so much back and forth with
that. Is that Johnny Depp's ex?
Yeah, you know, because of the beef and the rumours of domestic violence, which was never confirmed. And I think people are saying that she made it up and all this sort of shit. And Johnny Depp got kicked off Pirates of the Caribbean.
Is that what happened?
I think he got kicked off that one, yeah. Because of those rumours and the whole court case. And I think there was a whole petition against her, isn't it? Kicking her out of that. So, I mean, I read something. It could be fake news.
I don't
news.
Know, Leah, not, if we lawfully can say anything. But from what I heard on the papers, that she was having an affair. Because when they went to courts in London, didn't they?
Oh, and was the trial?
Yeah, it was in London. Okay. And when they got the what do you call it? Not the butler or the receptionist. He said, during that time... Oh, guess who was there during that time? This is deep.
Suge Knight.
No, Elon Musk.
Ah, yeah, because he's boys with...
Her.
What's her name? Yeah, Amber.
Yeah, so he had the
keys. Wait. Elon Musk and Amber Heard are
so when,
friends.
Well, this is...
Let's just say friends.
Yeah, some say he went to her house to mine for bitcoins, but who knows. Yeah,
he was
so
just being sure about yeah. Excuse me.
He was trying to look for some cobalt batteries from Amber Heard's.
That's
booty.
Why Bitcoin went so high, bro. Shit, this plug ain't working.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
And, how long have we got? It's going to die any minute.
How could it, what do you mean it's not working?
It doesn't fit the plug in because it's too far out.
Oh, God damn.
What's dying right now?
We're going to have to move on.
I just made a song up about...
The battery. What do you mean, man? It's a free...
You
just move the Blu-ray
Kibbs.
Player back.
No, it won't fit because of the space between
here. Put the laptop here.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Yeah, man. So,
a bit technical.
So when Amber Heard left, when she made all the allegation about Johnny Depp, when they done the time cross
helping with the mic.
It turns out Elon Musk was at the premises.
Oh, damn.
What, yeah. Elon Musk?
But one thing he was guilty of, he did, like... said I love you on his arm or chest.
Who's
doing
that? Johnny?
Yeah.
He did for
her.
Yeah.
Well, I think she's getting pushback because she accused him of domestic violence and that wasn't
Well, I know.
You wanna bring those pillows out the way, bro?
Oh, that's some succulent time,
huh? No, that's me, that's my poopy, bro.
No, fuzz.
Because after the whole trial, They kicked him out. Well, they fired him from Fantastic Beasts 3.
Yes, that was it.
Yeah. And they replaced him with the actor
Antonio Banderas.
No, not Antonio Banderas, man. What's the other gentleman's name?
Which guy?
He was in that movie Polar. Do you remember Polar?
Polar Express.
Oh.
And then he was in that Konami game. Is it Konami?
Yeah, Mad Mickelson.
Chuck Norris.
Is that his name, Kibbs?
Yeah, wow,
basically,
this one
will
go off.
What's his name, Kibbs?
Mad Mickelson.
Yeah, okay, I know him too.
He was Caecilius.
Yes. So I think they replaced him with him.
I think that's where, because of that, the fans tried to get rid of Amber Heard. But again, that's a bit more, I don't know. I guess that's the. If he didn't do that and she's accusing him of that, then that's fucked up. Because if he got cancelled because of that, which might not be true, then it's not fair. What's next? District 9-2 in the works.
Yo, can you give me a glass of water, please?
Stand out.
Well, you're standing up, aren't you? Please. Thanks, man.
District 9-2. Did you watch District 9?
Oh, no, but there's talks about District 9, isn't it?
Yeah, have you seen that yet? The one with the alien in South Africa.
South Africa.
South Africa. I love that accent.
That actor, I can't remember his name.
He's really good.
But he played Hannibal. Not Hannibal. Was it Hannibal in 18? No. No, it was... What are the names?
I forgot his name. I know 18 was...
18, you have B.A.
Murdoch.
Yeah, Murdoch. That's... Nah, I'm cool, man. Yeah, Murdoch. And you know what? He played such a good role.
Yeah.
And looked identical as the old actor.
But I remember in District 9, he was becoming an alien, right? He got infected, remember? Yeah. So I wonder how, if the part two is related on that, or just a whole complete different story. Oh, but wow. That'd be interesting.
It would be nice if they did a continuation of what happened to him.
Because
He was in love, right? He
was he?
I swear he had a girlfriend.
District 9,
he had a girlfriend, right? And then he was obviously turning into, thank you, he turned into an alien. Why has it all got fairy dust in it, bro?
What do you mean fairy dust?
I'm joking, bro. It's a little bit.
Oh, it's laughing, man.
District 9 too.
District 9. It was about that Australian guy.
Not Australian, South Africa. South Africa, man.
Yeah.
That was a good movie.
Australian guy in South Africa.
Well, did he...
Australian.
Did he do the voice for Chappie as well?
Yeah.
That was a good South movie. African
guy. Chappie was awesome. Not that Australian guy that lives in South Africa.
I swear I read something about Short Circuit.
Bro.
No, there's a reboot.
Yeah.
Is it going to be a white man playing an Asian guy again?
I hope not, bro. I hope not. That's a different level of Buddhism. But yeah, District 9 2. To be honest, I think the first one's a great movie. I don't think they did the number 2.
Yeah, I saw that one, actually. I read that one. Well, the Terminator.
They're very good Goonies, I heard, I think, wasn't it?
No, they wanted to do number 2, but they can't. They're all like 200 years over.
Yeah, they're old school, man. The next one was Terminator, an anime series, same writers as Batman.
Good.
What?
So, Terminator. But Terminator is that Fox now? Are they not Fox? Who's Terminator?
It's Fox. It was Fox, but it's gone to Paramount or something.
Oh. So Warner Brothers and whatnot. No, it doesn't. Actually, just because it said writers of Batman doesn't mean it belongs to Warner Brothers. No. Well, that could be interesting, I guess. I mean, maybe they could focus on the future. Maybe they use the animated series to focus on the future rather than, you know, John Connor and all that sort of stuff. They could just focus on...
They've got to stop that John Connor business.
Yeah, they could just focus on a complete different time. Just
give me a couple of soldiers in the future fighting Terminators. I'm happy with that. They tried that with Christian Bale about the laws and that one.
One and two were just the greatest.
They will always be.
You know what? I'll be honest, the last one that came out, I actually enjoyed that one.
The last one was good.
Because that one had the same format as the first two.
His one-liners destroyed it, man.
Yeah, it was good, but that girl annoyed the hell out of me.
Which girl?
The young girl. The new John Connor.
Oh, yeah.
Mm.
And then when they went to the future, she was still the same age,
yeah. She was.
Bro,
there was no different in her appearance.
She didn't even look like she was getting older.
Yeah, she was.
They just put it in Kane Rose.
Yeah. I think they were trying to say the Latinos on age, which is very well true.
Which is funny. That's cool.
She still looks younger than us.
Yeah, man.
I know, bro.
And she's what, 55?
50-something.
J-Lo.
Listen, bro. All I'm saying is they lose on that scene anyway. Because I remember when I saw that cinema... Actually,
we watched it with Dad. We watched it with Dad, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, and then that scene came out. I was like, "What the bomb? How'd they do that, man?"
But
they should have aged her.
Okay.
Mm.
Yeah.
They should have aged her.
But that movie was good, though. Out of all the new Terminators, apart from like from Terminals 3-2 onwards, that was the best.
The actor that played the bad guy.
He was sick.
Brilliant actor, man.
Well, he played the Ghost Rider in
he's
fucking awesome.
Guys, remind me, did it happen?
No, what, in the latest one?
Yeah. He does something like that.
He jumps in a thing again.
He goes, for Zon Connor.
Yes, he does. Yeah.
That got me, man.
That. Nothing will ever get you as Terminator 2.
No, bro.
Hey, Terminator 2.
Stop it, man.
Well, I tell you now.
No, there's one more.
Yeah.
And he just gets on there.
That was shit, yeah. Nothing
my wife
you,
still
man.
Cries.
Bro, it's deep, because... You know, the antagonist then becomes a protagonist, and then you have
to
say bye
to him. That's
what
they try to do in Tenet, don't they? But they lose.
Mm.
Did they?
Yeah, with the program, I can't even say the word right now.
Antagonist program, I can't even say antagonist. Either.
Too hot.
I don't even know what that means.
It means 1.2 gigawatts.
What else was there, man? There was Wesley Snipes working on a Blade Killer project.
Oh, yeah, I think he said that.
Blade Killer project. What do they mean by...
I think... I don't... It sounds like...
There's more munchies up in the place.
Really. Yeah, bring it up.
It sounds like... He's not involved in the Blade movie, and obviously he's been recasted.
Shadow needs to make a start, man.
By Mahershala Ali.
Shadow needs to make a start.
Mm. Oh, I'll make a couple, man.
Make
it,
man.
No, I'll make two.
Huh?
This is really nice.
They're the best, aren't
they? Where you get all your snacks from? From your bag?
With the tea, innit? What's that about, man? What were we on now? What were we talking about now?
Wesley Snipes working on a Blade Killer project.
Are you going to make a cup of tea?
I read something about that.
What, Project Killer?
When it says Blade Killer Project, I think he's talking about something that competes against Blade.
Also, what, another sort of vampire?
He tried that shit with Daywalker, man. Lose.
What was Daywalker?
Where he was like some cowboy vampire hunter.
Oh, but that was a basic
that
film.
That film was shit.
That film
with Wesley Snipes?
That film was so disappointing.
I
don't even know what that's about, man.
Lose, bro. I don't know
about
this.
Such a bad film.
You know, the trailers made it look so good.
It did.
And then when you watch the movie, he just got battered through the movie. Like,
yeah.
Like,
it was based on vampires as well, wasn't it?
I think it was.
It was called Daywalkers, bro. It was just... It wasn't... It wasn't a great production either. It was such a bad film. So I'm hoping he just let the studio take over.
Maybe this article's some bullshit clickbait thing, but when it says Blade Killer movie, it puts it out as Wesley Snipes is upset that he's being rebooted, so he's going to try and challenge.
No, but he's not, though.
But that's what I'm saying. I think maybe this is a clickbait article. So maybe it's not a Blade Killer movie. Maybe it's just another... interpretation of a vampire movie that he wants
what
to make.
What would be good is that he becomes the new Whistler.
Oh, yeah, but brilliant. I don't think they'll put him in there.
So good,
but he will
know.
Be sick, yeah. Mm.
That's a good idea.
Quads, you need to audition for it, man.
Yeah, bro, you need to sit around. Sorry, you guys are getting to see the back of my head.
That's not good, bro. Turn around, man. The next one was Daft Punk, bro.
Most
so after what? How many 28
years?
28 years. They decided to split. Did you read anything about it?
They just dropped the video, and I was watching the video, and I was like, "What the hell?" And then I started seeing that was their not breaking. They've just gone their separate ways now, haven't
they?
Well, but it's
the
a really nice. I think, bro. I don't think they could top their last album, bro. To be honest,
that was a good one.
Their last album.
Wait, was
so
that the
great.
One with
Pharrell and all them? Yeah.
But that was years ago. We're talking about. 10 years ago.
Oh,
yeah. 2011, 2012, something about
no,
that?
No, you had the Tron Legacy soundtrack, which was amazing. And then they did this album.
Brilliant.
I think Tron Legacy is probably one of their...
Best.
One of the best, greatest soundtracks ever, bro.
Brilliant.
Love that soundtrack. I'm not sure what happened on that one. But they've gone their own separate way. Whether they do music separately, it's up to them what they do. But yeah, it was just, I suppose, 28 years of people, of big fandoms that enjoyed it.
Right.
It's quite tough, man. You get the connection, isn't it? To be
honest, man, 28 years is remarkable.
Yeah.
So,
how
nobody's ever seen their faces.
Are they ever going to do a solo? Are they going to go solo or what? Because that might be...
I think they just need the rest now, man. I think
maybe they're just done. Alright, next thing on the list was some DC stuff, bro. So before we talk about the Superman stuff, quickly, Blue Beetle. They're looking to do a Blue Beetle movie.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
With a Mexican... Obviously, he's a Mexican superhero.
Who?
I'm not too familiar with him myself, but I did see the guy from Karate Kid, Miguel from Karate Kid's face. I don't think they've picked anyone, but... That's what they're looking to do, and I guess that's.
He kind of reminds me of a bit of a cyborg, but not as enhanced as cyborg.
No, and he's part of Titans as well.
Yeah.
So it'd be interesting for them to pick this character. It's a random character to pick, and then go with
they,
that.
Because they could have gone with maybe.
They're going for a massive change at the moment, as you saw. There's loads of news out as well. So let's head to the next one.
Well, the next news is what kills me now. A reboot of Superman, right? Is that the next news?
Well, you could talk about that. Reboot Superman.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
obviously,
man,
a black Superman.
Is that definite?
That's not even definite yet. We don't know.
They just said reboot.
Yeah,
so, where's this?
A black writer. It doesn't mean it's going to be a black Superman. We don't know that.
But they're talking about J.J. Abraham.
J.J. Abraham.
I love him. Always had it. Ever since Lost.
So, he's not directing it.
No.
Because a lot of people have been slating him.
Why?
Because they feel as that he's ruined is it Star Wars?
Yeah.
And they feel like he's gonna ruin Superman.
Like, you know what? Superman's been a passion project for him for years. Originally it was supposed to go to him.
Which one, Man of Steel?
Yeah.
Okay.
So he was supposed to do one. Bro, he did the casting for Henry Cavill in the suit for Superman, but then they chose Superman Returns instead.
Ah, okay, I see.
You know what I mean? That's how far it got to. So wow. Henry Cavill got a job as Superman from 10, 15 years ago.
Holy shit.
Well, how long has Man of Steel been out anyway?
Man of Steel's been out almost 9 years, bro.
Bloody hell.
So you can imagine for him, he just wants to give this guy a good couple, a trilogy.
Well, let's
see. I think all the... Okay. I didn't realize. I thought it was confirmed as a black Superman, so I didn't know that. So I don't know why people jump to conclusions. First of all, seeing Michael B. Jordan in the suit looks fucking awesome, so I have no issues with that anyway.
Listen, bro, he would be sick. I don't have any issues with a character's representation, as long as we get in good content, good story, And the thing is, to be honest, bro, like, the world's changing dramatically now, so changes in these sort of...
is good.
It's good. It's refreshing.
The only thing I have is like we haven't even had a DC and Warner Brothers. I don't know what's the problem, but I haven't even had enough of Henry Cavill. Give me more of him.
I know.
Finish that off first, then just reboot it.
I feel exactly the same way what you just said. They haven't given us enough. Literally, they gave Man of Steel, Batman vs Superman, and then Justice League.
That's his arc, bro.
Is it because the last two films are quite...
Listen, bro. They didn't give the director his creative freedom,
which we'll get in a couple of weeks.
Cutting it, and then we'll get in a couple of weeks. We get his vision of Justice League, but Batman v Superman, same thing. They released a cut version, which they should have released the ultimate version, which explains more, which makes you enjoy the movie.
I think
we
watched that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the ultimate.
Yeah, we watched that. Yeah.
That's much.
Which was not so much better. Yeah.
And then you're like, remember when we watched it? We're like, why the hell didn't they show us the cinema?
Yeah, exactly.
So if I feel like they put themselves in it for a bit, but yeah, I gotta be careful with my wording on this as well. So,
well, I think I've got an issue with a reboot in general.
Mm.
I don't care about. Again, if the Michael, there was talks about Michael B. Jordan being the Superman from before,
yeah,
right? Yeah, so he will be fucking awesome if they did it. I just haven't had enough of this current Superman that we've had now. So, you know, DC just doesn't know.
The problem is they don't have the Kevin Feige there. That's the problem.
Yeah, they just need to carry on. We need
to be honest, I just feel like with the issues that happened with Ray Fisher and the horrendous issues that were going on.
Ray Fisher had issues with
Warner Brothers.
Oh, so it was what's his name?
Joss Whedon. Warner Brothers had a problem in there. Jeff Jones from DC, and because he's been making a lot more noise, suddenly diversity suddenly kicked a big kickoff in other places. So,
well, listen, if that's the case, we just mentioned Blue Beetle, a black Superman, Mexican Blue Beetle. I think he's Mexican anyway, right?
Yeah, he is Mexican.
And then a black Superman, which in the comics they've had black Superman and whatnot.
Yeah.
I don't think it's that. I have no issues with that. It's just about a reboot. It's too soon.
I thought they would have bought Blue Beetle to Titans, because again, he is an original Titan, team member, isn't he? So I thought they would have maybe brought him in there.
The Superman show. Now, you said you've seen episode one and it's freaking awesome.
I
haven't given it a chance because DCW shows kill me, man, up eventually. But you're saying watch it.
How much cringe you put in there. And now you got a character that's coming from the Arrowverse, and I don't think they should connect it to the Arrowverse.
Well, the Arrowverse, like I said,
it's dead now.
Yeah. But like I said, when we spoke about CW shows, starts off brilliant.
And then it kind of... I just hope it continues.
All of them by season three.
It's a really good story. I feel like they grounded him even more.
Yeah.
Yeah, and because they've not focused on him as being, you know, Man of Steel, they're focused on him being a dad trying to raise up two kids and then hold a marriage together. That's the element that's changed.
Do you feel like because there's more history with Superman, they they're able to go down that line. That's a very risky thing for them to do.
First 15 minutes of the film, and you're like, holy shit, they actually did that. So they've started to learn to... I think the CW and Warner Brothers have learned that. You know what? We have 100 years of mythology.
Yeah.
Why didn't we use this from the beginning?
It, like I said, it's a big risk.
And it's hard to adapt books and comic books onto the TV screen anyway.
Because when people...
Yes and no. I think Marvel has shown that you can adapt comic books.
No, but remember, they changed everything as well.
They did.
No, but they were consistent.
Yeah, no, well, they wouldn't take a risk.
Because understand that.
Yeah, exactly. They explained and they DC were consistent.
DC would try and go around it.
Well, DC's all over the place.
I think they've struggled. It's hard. And the comparing of how I respect all
DC, Marvel. I just feel like Marvel's way ahead of the game, man. And DC,
of course they are, bro. They've started from a long time
DC,
ago.
I just wish they just took notes from Marvel side. Hey, look, they can
well,
do
but
it.
But don't remember, they have to be different as well.
No, they have to be different, but the amount of reboots, the amount of this and that. Superman, like I say, is one of their main characters and he's on a TV show. We haven't even got enough of him on the damn big screen.
This is
and
what
they
it
keep
is.
Putting
he's
on
been
TV
on
show.
TV shows from the beginning. He never
yeah, I know, I know, I know, but they keep doing it. But, you say watch it though, I might give it a chance, but
I'll be honest with you, like I said, Flash I still
after
watch.
After that opening scene, I was like, oh my god, I can't believe they did that. Well, it was actually a really touching scene, and they took it right from the comic books.
Yeah, well, like I saw the spoilers and spoiler alerts, I guess, if you haven't seen it, but it's literally that scene from Action Comics.
So
yeah.
They've made it more common, and even like where he says, so basically he saves a kid at the beginning, with that iconic scene, with the iconic suit.
I think I saw
it's a really cool, grounded scene where the kid was so excited and said, oh, I love your costume. And before he flies off, he goes, yeah, I love it too. My mum made it for me. And he flies off. Nice. It's like that cheesy Superman thing that we've always kind of... I've always... It's like almost a Christopher Reeve thing he did there.
I'm an
actor. I'm not so...
You know what they did to him in this? The other thing that pulled out was too much body pads.
I was just about to
because when
to
he's
that.
Clark, you're like, oh man, he looks skinny.
He looks skinny, yeah.
And then
yeah.
when he's in the suit, I was like, bro, he looks hench.
Hench, yeah.
But he looks. They've changed the suit.
Yeah.
Where he looks better now.
Yeah.
And they changed the color tones.
I don't think I'll give it a chance, man. I've kind of given up. Flash, loved it. Still watch it, but it gets boring.
Basically.
Arrow, just it started off brilliant and then just went down. DC Legends.
The problem is
tomorrow.
With what DC has done, what they shouldn't have done, is they've had. Everybody has turned into superheroes.
Mm.
Well, everybody knows, by the way.
And everybody knows. Everybody doesn't matter. Secret identities are hard to keep. In a comic book, remember, you're talking about a 20-minute segment. Where for us, when you watch TV, you're going to need more substance.
More substance.
So, and that shit won't fall now, like wearing glasses and be like, well, actually, if I take it off, I look like Superman. No, man. I look like a guy, it's 1 a.m. I need to go to sleep. My little girl's there by herself, man. But yeah, what's happening next?
The last thing is the big discussion that we've all been waiting for. WandaVision, episode 8, the second to last one. Now, this was a big episode, bro. This episode went back into her past, gave us a backstory of the show. And gave her a backstory of her mentality of where she got today. And obviously, after last week's episode of introducing Agatha Heartless, Hartney, it kind of expressed what she's involved, her involvement
is.
And then it's a big scene with the Hulk.
Yeah,
yeah, this is my favorite.
But I never forget how.
This is
moist.
Which is.
Cap, I'm always angry.
Brilliant, Steve.
That's my secret. I'm always angry. Boom.
Bro.
You've got a condition, son. Right, man, look at that.
When I saw the Avengers 5 times in the cinema, that always gave me goosebumps.
So it was like 7, man.
Yeah, man, butters, man. You see that? But yeah, guys, WandaVision, great episode. So much more backstory on Wanda. Remember, we never got an individual movie for her, so this is perfect. What they did, and we're gonna get it with all the characters that we fell in love with on the Marvel journey. There were some key scenes in there that grabbed us. basically the moral of that story was not the moral. What am I talking about? The thing that we got out of that episode was this is how they've introduced mutants. That she had it in her already.
That's what and Agatha
that
said.
Soul Stone bought it out of
that's
her.
What Agatha said. That she, something that she already had in her, the Soul Stone. Now, if that's the case, that means that they're saying that she was some kind of mutant. And maybe the Infinity Stones, and maybe the Click, because remember, it created an energy force around the world. Maybe that could be the they could be going back to that theory of giving exposing people's mutant abilities. But there was that, so we showed that, and there was that wicked scene of her seeing the Scarlet Witch. That was fucking awesome. So
that she was, got her name. It was given in this episode.
Finally, she was named the Scarlet Witch, which was sick. And obviously, this is about magic, right? So it's Agatha's magic, Scarlet Witch's powers, which is magic. And obviously, Doctor Strange, we know he's going to show up in the show, which will probably be in the next episode.
Do you think it's going to be him or somebody else?
Nah, it's going to be him. Doctor Strange. He's magic as well.
I don't think it's going to be him.
The one
they've made us... The thing is about Marvel, and we know this for now, for years, they've always misleaded us.
That is very true, yeah.
And I feel like it could be
Batman. Sorry, I just
Professor Xavier.
Nah.
No. So they're gonna do the Phoenix saga. I'm joking.
So basic and random. But
no, but this is almost
and it's gonna be Jennifer Lawrence as Professor Xavier.
Oh, fuck that, man.
They know they need Vin Diesel. Sorry.
No,
oh, yeah,
God.
Bro. He needs to. You know what? I'd love him.
Diesel as Professor.
I think he'd be wicked, bro.
For what? You're mad.
I live my life quarter of a mile.
He's wheelchair
rolling.
Nice shots on the wheelchair.
Basic.
Oh, God.
No, man. Brilliant episode. I think, obviously, they touched on how she created the hex.
Oh, why?
Right? That was all the. What was you saying? We were saying that this showed her after Age of Ultron. And the relationship she built with Vision then, he was there for her. He was new, right? As a human or whatever he was, Super Saiyan, that he was trying to emphasize with her. You saw how powerful she is when she created her own Vision in her little hex bubble. Oh. That was fucking amazing. The one thing I'm super disappointed about this episode is when they showed her parents and Magneto, her father. I didn't expect Michael Fassbender, but he should have been a Magneto type looking dude.
So just to stop you there, it was so funny. I mean, you're on the phone to your girl, and all I heard, it wasn't Magneto, it wasn't Michael Fassbender.
I was trying to explain to her that it wasn't. It should have been either him or it should have been a Magneto type figure. It should have been, bro. A very, you know, good shape.
It could have been Magneto, bro.
Nah, he. I'm sorry, that guy did.
Could have been an off-season.
That was an off-season Magneto, bro. Listen, they got the rights back, so I think they should have, at least, like I said, if it wasn't Fassbender, they should have put a Magneto-type looking dude. Pull it that way.
Don't forget, man, Magneto's always, you know... No, he was in love, wasn't he?
So where did Agatha pull out X-Men Quicksilver?
No, but she didn't recast him, remember? She said it. She goes, I didn't recast him.
Yeah, she said to him, you're so destroyed, you believed it was your brother. So that's what I'm saying. She knew that, Agatha knew that Scarlet Witch's head is all off the place. She didn't even say that. She said it was a random dude or something, but she said that you were so messed up that you even believed it was your brother.
But you pulled him from somewhere then.
But Scarlet Witch, she doesn't even recall on what she's done. So, what are you talking about? She doesn't really realize how powerful she is.
Yeah, wow, that's what. She's so emotional, and her PTSD has caused so many problems.
This episode showed it to us, man. Cause her having her own movie before this would never have made sense.
Exactly.
She's gone through so much;
sense.
It makes sense. But then, you know, the interesting scene was as well when not Shield, what they called Sword. Mm-hmm. Made her look out to be like
a bad guy.
Yeah, they had the whole video clip of her stealing Van Vision. That was never the case.
So that's the question now. Why are they hiding it? Why are they making it look to like a terrorist?
And then they did what they did, didn't
they? They did what they did at the end, which was they just needed... Well, they were trying to create Vision as a weapon.
Okay.
And so they just needed a bit of her power, right? Which was mad.
That, and do you think they're going to use him to fight Wanda and make out she's the terrorist and we got a good guy now? We're going to send him in. But in the comic books, he turns white, right? After the stone is removed, yeah. From what I remember.
That's right, yeah.
But did Vision always have an infinity stone in his head? Is that legit? I don't think that was legit.
No, that wasn't legit. No. He never had an infinity stone in his head.
But listen, they got one more episode.
Adam Warlock had it.
Yes, Warlock had it in his head, exactly. Vision, look, they got one more episode left. And
it could be Adam Warlock.
Nah, where's he gonna come? Why is he gonna go to come for this?
Bro, he's coming, bro.
No, but don't forget the stone. He's coming in Guardians. Right?
Yeah, no, she no, made him. That. She made it.
She made it, that's what
yeah.
I'm saying.
Sorry, yeah, bro, you're probably thinking boring.
But, listen, we got one more episode left. Now, Marvel keeps saying we got all this fake news about the last three episodes being 1 hour. Basic.
We got bumped.
But I do feel the last
40 minutes.
I do think they should. There's a lot more to explain because this has to lead on to Doctor Strange 2, or which comes first, Spider-Man. So this has to lead on to Spider-Man. But yeah, there's a lot to.
Does it have to lead on to Spider-Man?
Yeah, because it's the multiverse, right? So that's what they're leading on to. But I guess, look, I think the whole episode was awesome. I think they explained a lot. It's great they gave us a backstory. I'm still a bit... Two things for me is, like, you gave a backstory and you didn't show... When she broke into S.W.O.R.D. to get Vision's body, there was no supervision of any of the other Avengers, right?
Yeah, that
so
didn't make sense.
There was,
yeah.
There was that thing. So where was any of the Avengers? Why was she left alone? Think about it, man. Hawkeye went with his family, and Black Panther was back with his family, and everyone was back with their families, and she was left alone. Why? Right? So there's that wasn't explained. And two, I still wanted a Magneto type figure for her pops, not this basic looking dude.
Well, like I said, maybe their mum had a game with someone else.
Nah, man, that looked like a loving family. But then also, it made sense now why she went through those different years, right? The TV programs her and her family used to watch, with the Dick Van Dyke show and then all the way going to Malcolm in the Middle and all that sort of stuff. So I guess the different years now finally makes sense why she went through that, why she created this own world and how did that happen. So that was pretty good. I think that episode explained a lot.
Hulk. I love this bit. Pies him up.
This was awesome. I feel Marvel didn't express a good Hulk. I mean, not express a good Hulk, but I feel like...
No, he became a pansy towards
them. Yeah, we didn't get...
Yeah, he did.
The Hulk that we should have got.
Like, fair enough, they wanted to give us Professor Hulk.
I reckon this Hulk here would have gave Thanos a big challenge.
Yes.
Oh, 100%. This Hulk here. Yeah. But then as he grew as a character...
He lost his anger.
Yeah, man. It's kind of like... He lost it. But yeah, WandaVision. I mean, look, I think that episode gave us so much, man. It's so awesome. It didn't touch on Rambo, so we don't know what happened to her. But obviously, the final episode is the one that's going to hopefully clarify everything, man. But next Friday, last episode of WandaVision. Can't wait for that to see what happens.
I haven't seen any.
Watch it, bro. Steve.
Who's that downstairs, bro?
I don't know. I think it should be.
Can you just check, please?
All right, man.
Yeah, stop checking.
Let's see
if she's okay as well.
Go on, Kibbs. Close it out, bro.
Whoa. All
right, boys. All right, guys. Massive, massive thank you for everybody joining in for the Brothers Geek Out podcast 150, guys. Again, if you could check us out on YouTube. Actually, you're watching on YouTube. What the fuck am I talking about? Sorry, guys. Make sure you check us out on SoundCloud, Apple Podcast, and Spotify. And massive, massive thank you again for always on supporting the channel. Make sure you guys, a lot of you commented last week. Thank you so much. Let us know your thoughts again. It's really important because it helps us out as well. Shout out to a couple of people. Ahmed Rashid, who had 20 COVID tests in 3 days. We love you, bro.
Right. Check out the new Passion with Curtis that's come out.
Yes, and then the recent episode that came out with Curtis West. Make sure you check it out. The next episode comes out this Friday. It's going to be Ashley that comes out. So, guys, enjoy. Thanks again. Ahmed, shout out tomorrow. 20 COVID tests. One love. 3 days. Fathers. It means something.